This is Michael Takos with the Enterprise Data and Analytics team. Today I'm going to show you how to get a little more out of your Outlook calendar by analyzing it in Tableau. So our objectives for this video are to learn how to export your calendar from Outlook in a CSV file, to load that data into Tableau and to massage it a little bit, and then to analyze it in Tableau. So let's get started. First, we need to open up Outlook, and we need to navigate to our calendar. If you haven't categorized your calendar, you can still do this, but categorizing will give you a little bit more detail. To categorize a meeting, click on the meeting and click on Categorize and choose whichever color you like. You can edit the name of the various categories by renaming them in the All Categories section. You can also create new categories. So now go to File, go to Open and Export, Import Export, and then choose Export to a File. We're going to choose comma separated values, which is a CSV file. Make sure you have your calendar selected, and then choose where you're going to save your export to. I'm just going to dump my export to the desktop. All right, this step is optional, but it can help if you're having difficulty exporting a large amount of data from Outlook. The field description is a very large freeform text field. If you see it over here in the To section, remove it by moving it back over to From. Your export won't have the detail of all of your meetings, but it'll export a whole lot faster. Once you've done that, click OK. Click Finish. And Outlook is finally going to ask you what time frame are you interested in. Choose a time frame that seems appropriate. And click OK. So if we go find the file that we just exported, mine is on my desktop right here, test.csv. Now we need to load it into Tableau. So we need to open Tableau, and we want to connect to a text file, and we want to choose the CSV file that we just exported. Now we need to massage the data a little bit. You can see how our start date and our start time are two separate fields. We need to combine those fields and then subtract the start from the end. So right click and choose Create Calculated Field. We're going to name this Start Date Time. And this is the formula that we're going to use. We're going to take the start date, which is a date in Tableau, and turn it into a string. And then we're going to concatenate it with the start time, which is a string, and we're going to put a space in between them. If we hit apply, it'll show you that basically those two fields were just squished together. It's treating it as a string, and we actually want to treat it as a date time. And now it formats correctly. We want to do the same thing for end date and end time. So we're going to create another calculated field. We're going to call this one end date time. And you can see it's the same formula, just with end date and end time replacing start date and start time. This one is also a date time. And now we want to find the difference between start date time and end date time. So let's create a new calculated field and let's call it duration. And here is the formula that we're going to use. We're going to use the date diff formula. We're going to get our answer in minutes, and then we're going to find the difference in minutes between start date time and end date time. If we want it in hours, we could change minutes to hour, or we could divide by 60 and we would get duration in hours. So you can see I have a bunch of half hour one-on-ones. The last calculation that we're going to add is a calculation that'll tell us what the day of the week is. So let's create another calculated field off of start date. Let's call it day of week. And here is the formula that we're going to use. We're going to use date name. We're going to tell it that we want weekday, and we're going to pass in the start date. What this does is turns 4/7/2016 into Thursday. So now that we've massaged our data, let's do some analytics. Go to sheet 1, and let's break down by category where we spend most of our time in meetings. So drag categories to the field here, and then grab duration and drop it here. You can use the Show Me tab to change from a table of text to a visualization, and we can label these by dragging the category to the label. Let's make it a little bigger. So I have a lot of uncategorized time. So this visualization includes all day events, and I would like to exclude all day events. So we drop all day event on filter and we choose false. Now we're only looking at meetings that are from a definitive start and end time. Let's add a new worksheet. And because we know we're not interested in all day events, let's do the same filter. Let's grab duration again. Let's do a bar chart of the day of the week that we have the most meetings. So it looks like Monday is my busiest day, but let's look at it in bar chart form. And Monday is my busiest day by quite a lot, and Friday is my least busy day. Let's say we want to see where the categories break out over those days. We can drop it on the color field. And now we can see that my Mondays are dominated by workday and office hours and unknown. So let's do another worksheet and let's create a line chart. We'll start with duration and we'll grab start date. And we want to drill down to the day level. If we choose Show Me and choose Lines, these are reoccurring meetings that Outlook exported as part of the data set of the time frame that we were looking at. So let's clean up this chart. First, we need to grab our all day event and set that to false. And that looks quite a bit better. We can see that most of our actual meeting time for this export is between April and August. So let's grab start date and drop it on the filters field and choose a range of dates. And now we can see that my calendar is highly variable. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope it's been helpful. This is just the beginning of what can be done with Tableau. You might, for example, make a pie chart of who has sent you the most meeting invitations to see who's monopolizing your time in meetings. Or you might do a bar chart of locations to see which meeting rooms you prefer or which meeting rooms you spend the most time in. So this has been Michael Takos with the Enterprise Data and Analytics team. For more videos like this, please go to our website at itconnect.uw.edu/work/data, and under training, you'll find more videos.